The second star to the right shines in the night for you to tell you that the dreams you plan really can come true. The second star to the right shines with a light so rare, and if it's Neverland you need, its light will lead you there. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, so we'll know just where you are, gleaming in the skies above, to the land we're dreaming of. With a pinch of dust and happy thoughts, each time we say goodnight, we'll thank the little star that shines, the second from the right.
All this has happened before, and it will all happen again. This time, it happened in London, on a quiet street in Bloomsbury. This is the home of the Darling family. And this particular house was chosen because there were people here who believed in Peter Pan.
Cinderella flew through the air, far from all things ugly and ordinary. When she landed at the ball, she found herself most impertinently surrounded by pirates. There was Alf Mason, so ugly, his mother sold him for a bottle of musket. And Bill Jukes, every inch of him tattooed. And worst of all, Hook! Eyes, blues forget-me-nots, save when he clawed your belly with the iron hook, which he hasn't been on the left hand, at which time his eyes turned red. Girlie, said Hook, we have come to eat Lumpson. Who are you to order me about and call me girlie? Take that! Peter Pan swoops to the rescue! Take that! Take that! What is it that happened? There's nothing there! Hook came at her! And what happens then? What happens then?
The brave Cinderella settled the matter once and for all with her revolver.
With her revolver?
The night on which the extraordinary adventures of these children may be said to have begun was the night Nana barked at the window, but there was nothing there, not a bird, nor a leaf. So the children forgot about it, for what troubles a grown-up will never trouble a child.
Thank you, Liza.
Oh, it's so good of you to visit.
Oh, my dearest George, dear Mary, what a journey I have had.
Oh, Mother, you look simply lovely.
Why, thank you, dear. It's simply my old gown made over, but it's rather lovely, isn't it?
There never was a happier, simpler family. Mr. Darling was a banker who knew the cost of everything, even a hug. Mrs. Darling was the loveliest lady in all of Bloomsbury, with a sweet mocking mouth that always had one kiss upon it that Wendy could never quite get. Though there it was, perfectly conspicuous, on the right-hand corner. And sometimes there was Aunt Millicent, who felt that a dog for a nurse levered the whole tone of the neighborhood.
All right, all right, all right. Settle down. Less noise, please, children. This is not a farm.
Thank you, George. When the romp ended, most unluckily, Nana collided with Mr. Darling, covering his trousers with hairs. Not only were they new trousers, but they were the first he had ever had with braid upon them, and he had to bite his lip to stop the tears from coming.
You know, really, Mary, I don't think it's a good idea to have a dog for a belly.
But George, Nana is a treasure.
That may be true, my dear, but sometimes I think she looks upon our children as puppies.
Wendy, will you tell us another story?
All right.
Please, Wendy, tell us a Checo who carved his name on the governor of Goa and noodle him with his hands on backwards.
Heavens!
Hook!
Hook?
Hook, whose eyes turn red as he guts you.
Oh, upon my soul! Our children are educated nowadays.
Quite.
I'm afraid I'm not learned at all, Aunt, but I do know a thing or two about pirates.
Oh?
My uncle for the mission is to write a great novel, in three parts, about my adventures.
What adventures?
Well, I don't get to have them. They'll be perfectly thrilling.
But, child, novelists are not highly thought of in good society. And there is nothing so difficult to marry as a novelist.
Marry?
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 Aunt Wendy's not yet 13.
A walk toward me, dear, that I may appraise you.
Go on, walk to your aunt. Stand up straight. Be quiet.
Turn around. Oh, yes, it's quite as I expected. Wendy possesses a woman's chin. Have you not noticed? Observe her mouth. There, hidden in the right-hand corner. Is that a kiss?
A kiss? Like mother's kiss?
A hidden kiss.
But what is it for?
Oh, it is for the greatest adventure of all. Those who find it slip in and out of heaven.
Find what?
The one the kiss belongs to.
My Wendy? A woman?
Almost a woman. She must spend less time with her brothers and more time with me. She must have her own room, a young lady's room.
Leave the nursery?
George, the daughter of a clerk cannot hope to marry as well as that of a manager. You must attend more parties, make small talk with your superiors at the bank. Wit is very fashionable at present.
Wit? Now, Mary, we really must be off. And I must warn you, Mary, that unless this tie is around my neck, we do not go out to dinner tonight. And if we don't go out to dinner tonight, then I don't go to the office tomorrow. And if I don't go into the office, then we shall be poor, Mary. And our children shall be flung out onto the streets.
Then do please stand still, dear.
The situation is becoming quite desperate. I'm completely at my wit's end. However hard I've tried, I can't tie this wretched tie, and it's driving me quietly round the bend. My dearest, there is something I must promise, but I don't give up without a fight. But unless it's round my neck, in less than half a sec, we don't go out to dinner tonight.
Done. Yes, we are darlings. Everyone's a darling.
And remember, tomorrow you begin your instructions with Aunt Millicent. It's time for you to grow up. And Nana is a dog, not a person! Look at my tie! That's it! I had enough! Nana, out! From now on, you sleep outside like other dogs. And that may help you to grow up. Come on, after you. I've had enough. Listen, honestly, I put up with this dog for I don't know how many years. Oh, I'm sorry you had to see that. Really, it's absolutely ridiculous.
Oh, been going outside like a common dog.
Mother Nana has never slept outside.
Without Nana here, can anything harm when the night lights are lit and you are gone?
No, my precious. They are the eyes a mother leaves behind to guard her children.
Mother, must you go to the party?
Yes, Mother, you don't have to go.
Father can go by himself.
By himself? Well, your father is a brave man, but he's going to need the special kiss to face his colleagues tonight.
Father, brave.
There are many different kinds of bravery. There's the bravery of putting others before oneself. Now, your father has never brandished a sword or a pistol, thank heavens. But he's made many sacrifices and put away many dreams for this family.
Where did he put them?
He puts them in a drawer. And sometimes, late at night, we take them out and admire them. But lately, it's getting harder and harder to close the drawer. He does. And that is why he is brave. All quite quiet and still. Oh, how I wish I didn't have to go to this party tonight.
I sure nothing can harm us, Mother.
I'm quite sure, dear. Good night, children.
Peter! Peter! Oh no!
Tink, where are you?
I'm in here.
Oh, do come out of that jug and tell me, you know they put my shadow.
Yes, in the top drawer. Oh, your shadow doesn't want to be found. Come on, Peter. You're younger. Take hold of him. You're winning. Come on, Peter. Careful.
Stupid shadow. Peter Patton.
Is that all?
Yes.
Sorry.
Doesn't matter.
Where do you live?
Second start to the right and straight on till morning.
It's a funny address.
No, it's not.
Well, I mean, is that with any letters?
Don't get any letters.
But your mother gets letters.
Don't have a mother.
Oh, Peter, no wonder you were crying.
I wasn't crying about mothers. I was crying because I can't get my stupid shadow to stick on. Besides, I wasn't crying.
It's come off.
Yeah.
I could sew it on for you if you like.
What's sewn?
You are dreadfully ignorant.
No, I'm not.
This may hurt a little.
Ow!
Perhaps I should have ironed it. Might I borrow your knife? Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Sure, when I'm pleased with myself. You know, one girl's worth more than 20 boys.
Do you really think so?
Yes, because I live with the Lost Boys. They are well named.
Who are they?
They are the children that fall out of their prams when the nurse is looking the other way. They're not clean in 7 days. They are sent to the Neverland, and I'm their captain.
Are there girls too?
Oh, no. Girls are much too clever to fall out of their prams.
Oh, Peter, it's perfectly lovely the way you talk about girls. I'd like to give you a kiss. Don't you know what a kiss is?
No, and I shall know when you give one to me. I'm supposed to give you one now.
If you please. Chain around my neck. How old are you, Peter?
I don't know. I think I'm quite young.
Don't you know?
No. I ran away. Once, I heard my parents talking about what I wanted to be when I was a man. So, I ran away to Kensington Gardens. What happens when you're grown up? What happens when you're tall?
Shadows can no longer be sewn up.
In your childhood, things are too small. Wendy, I'm sure, rattled. Life is a bore. Becoming 13 is no joy. So instead of school and then studying law, I decided to stay as a boy. See, Wendy, I never want to become a man. I always want to be a boy. Wendy, I'm sure, battles. Life is a bore. Becoming 13 is no joy. So instead of school and then studying law, decided to stay as a boy. I ran away from home the day I learned the truth, and I went to Kensington Gardens. I don't care to wash my face speaking when I'm spoken to. For me, there's no begging for pardon. Wendy, you must understand your parents' life is hard. Dressed up fine and looking grand, it's only a facade. Too much responsibility and all the being a man. There's one boy you won't grow up, that's Peter.
But Peter, you can't just stay as a boy all your life.
Understand your parents' life is hard. Dressed up fine and looking grand, it's only a facade. Too much responsibility involved in being a man. There's one fool you won't grow up.
One boy who can't grow up.
There's one fool you won't grow up. That's Peter Pan. Where's Tinker? Skipping all about, and that was the beginning of fairies.
But there's no such thing as a fairy.
Never say that. Every time someone says that, a fairy someone falls down dead. And I shall never find her if she's dead.
You don't mean to tell me that there's a fairy in this room?
She was here just a moment ago. We come to listen to the stories. The one about the prince. Couldn't find the lady.
Cinderella! Peter, they found her and they lived happily ever after.
I knew it. There, did you hear that?
All I can hear is the tinkle of bells.
That's fairy language. I think you hear her too.
I'm in the drawer! Peter! You shut me the drawer, Peter! Peter, I should like to give you a thimble.
What's that?
You won't give Peter a thimble! I know what that is! She's a great ugly girl, and I'm your fairy!
She's not very polite. She says you're a great ugly girl, and that she's my fairy.
If she tries to give you a thimble again...
Try to give me a thimble again?
I'll pull her hair so hard, it'll come out, and she'll be bald.
She'll pull your hair out, and she'll be bald.
Oh, and I was supposed fairies to be charming.
Tinkerbell's quite a common fairy. She's called Tinkerbell because she mends pots and kettles.
Peter, don't go!
I have to tell the rest about Cinderella.
But I know lots of stories. Stories I could tell the boys.
We don't need her, Peter.
Come with me.
I cannot fly.
I'll teach her to ride the wind's back. And away we go. You just think happy thoughts. And they lift you into the air. It's easy. Come away to the Neverland. Wendy, let me teach you to fly. Follow me to the Neverland. Through the stars we'll soar up high. It's not far to the Neverland. There are fairies and mermaids too. Let me off to the Neverland. Oh, Wendy, the lost boys need you. Girls, what they say, seeing you come their way. I can tell them I brought them a mother. Stories one after the other. fly. He followed me to the Neverland, to the stars we'll soar up high. It's not far to the Neverland, there are pirates and Indians too. Let me off to the Neverland.
Mother bedtime stories. Oh, it's heavenly!
Then what are we waiting for? Come away. Come away to the Neverland.
Peter, what about father and mother?
Forget them. Forget them all. Come with me, or you'll never have to think about grown-up things ever again. What is it? What's wrong?
Never is an awfully long time.
There are mermaids.
Mermaids?
And Indians. And pirates.
Pirates? Then let's go at once. Get them out.
Returns to Neverland, the island wakes up again. On the morning of Peter's return, everyone was on the move. Put your ear to the ground, and you can hear the whole island buzzing with activity. The Lost Boys were out looking for Peter. The pirates were out looking for the Lost Boys. The Redskins were looking for the pirates. And the animals were looking out for the Redskins. First of all, here is Tootles, the gentlest and saddest of the Lost Boys. He is also rather brave, but has had fewer adventures than the other boys, It's just that, whenever things happen, he always seems to have just stepped around the corner to do something. When he comes back from collecting sticks or whatever, the other boys will be sweeping up the blood. But Tootles had better watch out today, because Tinkerbell is bent on mischief, and she needs help. Tink thinks he's the most easily tricked of the boys. Next comes Nibs, a cheerful lad. And then there is Slightly, who always thinks he can remember when he was a baby, in the days before he was lost. Now here is Curly, who is forever in trouble, often taking the blame for the other boys' naughtiness. And there are the twins, but I cannot tell you what they are like, for fear of describing the wrong one.
Okay, so, just keep on doing it. So basically what you do, so you pull back the bow, it's easy. Just
pull back? Okay.
Pistol first.
Those filthy, rotten little lost boys, they hate so much Captain. I could have put a bullet in them.
Aye. And the sound it would have brought Tiger Lily's natives upon us. Do you want to lose your scalp?
You should I after him, Captain, with Johnny Corkscrew here. Johnny's a silent fellow.
Not now, Smee. He's only one of them, and I want them all.
Oh, the Captain wants them all! So, unwrap your plan.
The plan is simple. We will bake a large, rich cake of a jolly thickness with green sugar on it. We will place the cake by the mermaid's lagoon. The boys are always hanging about there, talking to the mermaids. They will find the cake, and they will gobble it up, for having no mother, they don't know how dangerous it is to eat rich, damp cake. They will die.
Oh, Captain, tis the wickedest, prettiest policy I've ever heard of. And how do you reckon to make rich, damp cake?
Tim with baking powder, get some butter and some sugar. Collect some fruit and nuts galore. A few ounces of flour to give it extra power, with 21 eggs or more. Cream margarine, then add a little strychnine, a vital ingredient. Make no mistake, my dear Smee, don't you see? We now have a recipe of a voluptuously dangerous rich damp cake.
Rich damp cake.
Rich damp cake. Poor little lost boys easily led.
Rich damp cake.
Rich damp cake. One little bite and you'll find them dead. Ah, Smee. Then we'll put it in the oven and wait till it has risen and cover it with sugar that is green. And in case it's not enough for that lovely sickly stuff,
add a little more strychnine.
Shut up, Smee, and then to make it green, smooth all the poisonous cream and place it by the mermaid's bed, for they don't have a mother, a sister or a brother.
Oh!
most of all, Smee, I want their captain, Peter Pan. 'Twas he cut off my hand. I have waited a long time for revenge. Oh, I'll tell
him. Yet I've often heard you say that one hook is worth a score of hands for combing the hair and other homely uses.
Peter flung my hand to a crocodile. Do you know that, Smee?
I have noted your strange fear of crocodiles.
Not of crocodiles, but of that one crocodile. It liked my hand so much, Smee, that it has followed me ever since. From land to land, and sea to sea, licking its lips for the rest of me.
In a way, it's a sort of a compliment.
I want no such compliments. I want Peter Pan, who first gave the brute its taste for me. It would have had me before this sneer, but for a lucky chance. It swallowed a clock, which goes tick-tock inside of it. And so before the beast can reach me, I hear the tick and bolts.
And yet, one day, that clock will run down, and then it'll get you.
Aye, that's the fear that haunts me.
It's a bear!
I'm not sure. Ah, Princess Tiger Lily. We search, as ever, for Peter Pan and his secret hideout. Luckily, two boys of his acquaintance were seen falling into this part of the jungle. Have you seen them?
She says, sorry, but no.
My hook thinks you have, Princess.
I say, unhand the lady, you savage!
Get them!
Come on!
We'll make you talk, girlie. It's a crocodile! Ah, get me away from here! Hurry!
Just bring the chair! You know how the captain feels about the crocodile!
Thank you.
but it is a lady.
And Tootles! Tootles at Timber!
Aha, I'm back. Great news. I know what happened to Cinderella. They were slicing, stabbing, killing, torturing. And they lived happily ever after.
Well, that's only if I must say great news!
Greater news. I know. I brought you she who has taught us of Cinderella. She's here to tell us stories. She is...
dead. Tragic. Awful. Good job, though.
Yeah.
Who's arrow?
Mine, Peter. Strike, Peter. Strike, Trojan.
When he lives?
My kiss saved her.
I am a kiss, let me see it. Aye, that's a kiss. A powerful thing.
Yeah. Ooh, let us carry her down to the house, Peter.
Yeah, yeah.
Hands. They're a bit dirty.
She must stay here and die.
Slightly.
What could I forget about? Stupid. Sorry.
We must build a house around her.
Yes! Yeah, she
can help us! Doors!
Tink did it!
Tinkerbell, though, Tinkerbell.
Yes?
Was it you, Tink? Did you tell the boys to shoot Wendy down?
Yes!
Then I'm your friend no more.
I bet she wants a pretty house, the cutest ever seen, with funny little leafy walls and a roof of mossy green. Sorry about the blindfold.
You must be cautious.
That's a nasty
the best we've ever.
Don't worry, she's nice.
Yeah, she can.
There will be there.
If Hook discovers our hideout, he'll gut
her. Dreadful!
Oh, we live for it. Time to be mother, father.
We're so looking forward to being your son.
Welcome, mother. Is what fathers believe in. We must spank the children before they try to kill you again.
No.
In fact, we should kill them.
No! 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 No!
I agree. They are perfectly horrid. Kill them, and they shall think themselves important.
So important.
I suggest something far more dreadful. Medicine. It's the most beastly, disgusting stuff. The sticky, sweet kind. For everyone. Every day. Michael? Michael. John. My brothers!
Who?
With all things mysterious. If anyone knew who had captured Wendy's brothers, the mermaids would know.
you like to meet them?
Oh, Peter, I'd love to!
Hello, girls.
It's Peter. Oh, Peter. I'm so glad to see you. Why did I stay away so long?
I've been busy. Listen, have you seen two new boys around lately?
Of course we have, haven't we, girls? Yes. Of course.
Oh, no!
Yes. He captured two boys and Tiger Lily.
Tiger Lily?
She's the alien princess. This must be serious.
Did you miss me?
Tell us all your adventures.
Something exciting.
How about the time I cut off Luxana and fed it to the
Peter! Copper?
I've always liked that one.
Me too.
So there I was, a skull
of Luxana by 50.
Who's she?
Her. Well, that's Wendy.
A girl. What's she doing here?
And in a nightdress, too.
Come on, dearie. Join us for a swim.
Please,
Wendy, they were only trying to have a little bit of fun, weren't you, girls?
That's all.
We only wanted to drown her.
You see?
Well, you think for 1 minute that I'm going to have the fun to be...
Fish were each of the home.
Yeah, it's Hook, all right. He's got your brothers. And Tiger Lily. Come on, hide behind the tree.
Like all surprise attacks, it must be conducted improperly. But the children on the rock.
Get out of there.
Get out.
Oh, God.
Princess.
Get out. Yes. Sorry, Princess. Any last words? Beg for your lives.
Eso suplican por vuestras vidas.
Sirs, my brother and I are English gentlemen. English gentlemen do not beg.
Please!
Please!
Please! Please! No water but contain these in the fish. All in there.
Come on, Pan. Fly to the rescue. Then I'll shoot you right through your noble intentions.
Wendy, I have these two. You know how to use one?
I think so.
Promise me one thing. Leave Hook to me.
I promise.
Thus it was that Wendy first laid eyes on the dark figure who haunted her stories. She looked into the piercing blue eyes and was not afraid, but entranced.
It's Hook!
Shh, Wendy.
Did you hear that?
It's an evil spirit, Captain.
Stand by, Smee, while I take a look around.
Wendy, watch this. This'll be fun.
Fun?
Mr. Smee! You lovers!
That you, Captain? And who's there?
Brimstone and Gold Man! What do you think you are doing?
We put the children under the rock, like you said.
Set them free.
Set them free? But what about your trap?
Yes! Cut their bonds or I'll plunge by hooking you!
Tell me what he wants with them! I'm just a blithering idiot, I am!
Oh, better do as a captain orders!
Here, take that cat with you!
Oh, am I not a wonder? Oh, I am a wonder.
Mr. Smee!
Captain?
Captain?
Oh, Captain!
Any sign of him?
Oh, no, none.
Where are the children?
Oh, it's all right. We set them free, as he said, yeah.
You what?
Well, we let them go, like, just as you said, yeah?
You set them free? Yeah. You set them free?
Yeah.
Oh!
Oh, no!
Oh, man! Oh! Me! He shot me! Oh, no! Oh, no.
You are not! You are not! Brimstone and gall! Say that again, and I will cast anchor in you!
Tell me then, stranger, if you are Hook, then who am I?
You are a codfish.
Codfish? And have you another name? I've got a funny feeling there's more to this than meets the eye. We're facing one small problem. You say you're a Hook, but so do I. Hook, have you another voice?
I do, so take your choice.
And another name.
Aye, it's not the same.
Questions to me?
Oh, I can't think of a thing.
Can't guess. Do you give up?
Yes.
Speak clear and straight if you can.
Very well then, I am Peter Pan.
What? And now, Peter Pan, you shall die.
To die shall be an awfully big adventure.
Shoot it!
done. Wahali!
The warrior is wounded. She is calling forth the spirit of the ego to heal the warrior. It's so impressive.
Tanwahadi. Ali Sokwa Lopati. Tanwahali.
The warrior is healed. Thank you.
Kid, great big little panther.
Tiger Lily, my daughter.
Father, all the pirates, Hook and Smee, they took us to Skull Rock. The tide nearly drowned us.
But daughter, are you well? How you escaped the pirates?
Peter Pan rescued me. He imitated Hook's voice and set me and the boys free.
God of Sun, protect great white Father Pan. Himba Hula Peter Pan.
Himba Hula Peter Pan.
Himba Hula Peter Pan.
Himba Hula Peter Pan.
Himba Hula Peter Pan.
Himba Hula Peter Pan.
Father, we must protect the Lost Boys and the Wendy.
We will fight the pirates.
Thank you.
bringing me to believe, isn't it, that you and I are...
Oh, yes.
You see, Wendy, it would make me seem so old to be a real father.
Peter, what are your real feelings?
Feelings?
What do you feel? Happiness? Sadness? Jealousy?
Jealousy? Tink.
Anger?
Anger. Hook.
Love?
Love?
Love.
I've never heard of it.
I think you have, Peter. And I dare say you felt it for something or someone.
Never, even a sound of it, then, as well.
Peter!
Why do you spoil everything? We have fun, don't we? I taught you how to fight and how to fly. What more can there be?
There's so much more.
What else? What else is there?
No. I think it becomes clear once you grow up.
I'm not growing up. I will banish you like Tinkerbell.
I will not be banished.
Then go home. Go home and grow up. I've told you, but you still don't understand, do you? How can I explain? You still don't know me now.
Please, if only listen to me.
Where can I start? I just don't know how. Tell me a story, then we can pretend.
No, you never stop to ask where will it end. So look at us now, did the dream disappear? We're two worlds apart, so why am I here?
Open your eyes, come on, what do you see? I can't be the person you want me to be. And why? Just tell me, why would you ask me to change for you? Why should you want me to? And when? It's all going wrong.
If he'd listen, I know I could show him a way.
Pretend just a little and you'll find you'll belong.
I don't want to hear you, is all he can say.
To be talking like this, I can't understand. And what would become of the stories we planned? So why?
Why?
Just tell me, why would you ask me to change for? So
why?
Go on, tell me why you believe I grow up your way. And do I have no say about me?
Chair, exhausted from searching the heavens for her lost children.
Wendy, Wendy, Wendy.
We can't both have her, lady.
Cakes, me.
Indeed, if it weren't for the poison, they would have been delicious.
Oh, well, and those mermaids. Oh! Oh, oh, oh! Oh, this seat is hot!
Captain, what happened?
It's Bob Thomas and Thomas and Slimy Man!
Oh, what can it be? What is it? What's hot?
It's a chimney.
Chimney?
Oh, that's it, Captain! We found them! Just clear the lost boys live here beneath the ground!
It's gotta be it.
Oh, now we have them, lads. The cake can wait. This is what we'll do. Oh,
yes.
Yes.
Oh, what's this happening? More evil than this encounter. Fantastic.
I've waited so long to get them.
Fantastic.
What happened?
And so the doors have a cheer of joy. And the prince marries Snow White. And they live happily ever after.
Yay!
They live happy, children.
I love
you. The adventure that we've had.
A turn!
What would Mother think of her children if she could see them now, Wendy is thinking. But the more Wendy thought about her mother, the less she seemed to remember her.
A turn!
John, this is
so funny! John!
Yes? Who is your father, John?
My father? Peter!
Who is your mother?
He got the easy one.
Yeah. You are my mother, Wendy.
And you're just first class.
Yeah. Yeah.
We are going home.
Oh, Neverland. What an idea.
Look, we have forgotten our parents. We must go at once, for we in turn are forgotten. I forgot my parents. We must leave.
If you wish it.
If you wish it.
If you wish it. I've arranged for a guide to take you back home.
Peter, we've been talking and the lost boys would like to come back with us.
Peter, can we please go?
Can you please go?
Can they come with us?
If you wish it.
Get your things.
Yeah.
You too, Peter.
Would they send me to a school?
Yes.
Then to an office?
I suppose so.
Soon I shall be a man. You cannot catch me and make me man. I will always be a boy, and I will always have fun.
You say so. But I think it is your biggest pretend. Don't forget your medicine.
I'm so excited. Have you got everything
else? I can't believe
you're going to eat.
By surprise, a sure proof that the unscrupulous Hook had conducted it improperly. For to surprise the Redskins fairly is beyond the wit of the white man. By all the unwritten laws of savage warfare in Neverland, it is always the Redskins who attack first. They would creep through the night and attack at dawn. The pirates always knew they were coming, because of the coyote calls the Redskins make between themselves. Thus, the Indians trusted this day to the honor of Hook. The sudden, dishonorable attack took them completely unawares. They seized their weapons, and the air was torn with war cries, but it was too late. The pirates had won.
Thank you.
won.
If the Indians have won, they'll play the tom-tom, which is always their sign of victory. The tom-tom, an Indian victory.
Yay! Yeah!
It's safe to go.
Come on,
a most dreadful poison, distilled when he was weeping from the red of his eyes. It was a mixture of jealousy and disappointment. Just 5 drops would be instantly fatal, and it was without antidote.
Well, well, well. What have we here? Medicine. That will suit my purpose. And so, Peter Pan, to even the score, I am here to bid you good night. Now your end has been planned, I'm not at all sure. I want to finish the fight. It's a sad way to go, but you must understand, I couldn't continue to wait. And I'm sure you must know, when you cut off my hand, you finally sealed your fate. Poison! Goodbye, Peter Pan! My poison is strong, and you'll find there is no antidote. Adieu, Peter Pan! It will not take too long for the stuff to stick in your throat. Farewell, Peter Pan! Your demise will be quick. I've made it a fast-working brew. So long, Peter Pan, just one simple lick. Well, I'm sure it's the end of you. Goodbye, Peter Pan, the battle is won, and it seems a victory's mine. Adieu, Peter Pan, the name Hook will evolve, whilst your memory will decline. Farewell, Peter Pan, you cease to exist. I find that it's almost a shame. So long, Peter Pan, it's the ultimate twist. For we've come to the end of the game. Take your medicine for dear welcome's sake. Adieu, Peter Pan, when it passes your lips, you'll sleep and never awake. Farewell, Peter Pan, I'll miss you, you know. It's like saying adios to a friend. So long, Peter Pan, you gave a good show, but your story has come to an end.
one sip from your cup, and you will go out like a light. Farewell, Peter Pan, when I think of the years I waited for this, I could cry. I'll even admit, I'll weep crocodile tears. Crocodile tears, oh witty hook, to honor your past, to wish you at last, my dear Peter Pan, good
calm down. The pirates won.
I am calm. Listen, the Indians lost, and Hook has the boys, and Wendy.
I must rescue them at once.
Hurry.
Wait, my medicine. Wendy would never forgive me.
No, it's poisoned.
Who could have poisoned it?
It was Hook while you were asleep.
How did Hook get down here?
He did.
You're just saying that because you don't like Wendy. You're jealous.
No, don't drink it.
Tinkerbell, you drank it.
Yes, I told you. Hook poisoned it.
Oh, Tink, did you drink it to save me?
Yes, it was poisoned, Peter. Now I'm going to be dead.
Oh, why, Tink? You're growing cold.
Go and save Wendy and the boys.
Oh, don't die.
Do the children believe in fairies?
What did you say?
I said, do the children believe in fairies?
Of course they do.
If they do, they can save me.
They must, they will, they do.
Hold me, Peter.
Tink. Tink! I appeal to all the children, to every one of you. Say you believe in fairies. It's the least that you can do. He's waiting for your answer. A clap, a shout, a cry. Don't let him down, everyone. Don't let his Tinkerbell Tinkerbell?
Yes!
Then let's go. This time it's Hook or me.
Chained up, so they cannot fly away?
Aye, aye, so they are, Captain.
Then bring them out. There is room on this ship for a storyteller.
I'd rather die.
Shame. Where is he? You'll tell one last story before you die. The story of Peter Pan. Once upon a time.
Once upon a time.
Oh, Groot! The wind is going to tell us a story. Oh, get over him!
There was a boy named Peter Pan who decided not to grow up.
Skip the prologue.
So he flew away to Neverland, where the pirates are.
Was there a pirate called Bonnie?
Yes.
Oh, Captain!
Oh! Whoa! That's one down already! It's a very exciting story.
What fun he must have had.
Yes, but he was rather lonely.
Lonely? He needed a Wendy.
I need a Wendy.
Two down. It's getting dangerous.
Why a Wendy?
He liked my stories.
What stories?
Snow White, Cinderella, Sleeping Beauty.
Love stories.
Adventures in which good triumphs over evil.
They all end in a kiss. A kiss. He does feel. He feels for you. She told him stories. He taught her to fly. How?
You just think happy thoughts. They lift you into the air.
Alas, I have no happy thoughts.
That brings you down.
And what of Pam? Will unhappy thoughts bring him down?
He has no unhappy thoughts.
Yeah!
What if is Wendy walks a plank. You know, I really am terribly sorry about this. Oh, the irony. It comes for Hook and gets stories.
Did you hear her hit the water? Because I didn't.
The beast has swallowed her whole. Then let's give it more. Silence! Puling spawn. I'll show you the road to dusty death.
James Hook, this is all my doing.
Proud and insolent you! Prepare to meet thy doom.
Have a thee.
She was leaving you, Pat. Your precious Wendy was leaving you. Why should she stay? What have you to offer her? You are incomplete. She'd rather grow up than stay with you. Let us now take a peep into the future. What's this I see? 'Tis a fair Wendy alone in the nursery. The window is shut.
I'll open it.
The window is barred.
Call her name.
She can't hear you.
No.
She can't see you.
Wendy.
She's forgotten all about you.
Stop. Please. Stop it.
And what's this? There's another taken your place. And he is called husband.
No. No.
You will die alone, and unloved.
Say no more.
Just like me.
No! You!
Silence all! For Wendy's farewell.
sorry, Peter. I have to go. This is for you.
What? No!
It's just a thimble!
How like a girl! Very well then, my beauty. Give Peter Pan your precious thimble.
This belongs to you, and always will.
Silence, you dogs. I'll make you octopus.
Sam.
They've gone, Tinkerbell. They've left us alone.
Yes, Peter, they've gone. They really have.
Dreams, that she thought this was just the dream hanging around her still. But then...
Oh, it's really you! Where the hell, Michael? George! George, what have you there?
I'm coming, Mary.
What is it?
I mean, you're back. Very good. Well done. Excellent. Oh, of course I missed you, my angels.
All right, boys. Follow me. Get your hands off that wallpaper. Now, come along. The silliest thing, these young gentlemen say that...
Mother, father, these are the lost boys.
Hello!
Cats! May I keep them?
Do you think we should be too much of a handful, sir? Because if so, we can go away.
Well, I mean, the expense.
Think of the neighbors.
Father!
We can sleep doubled up.
Yeah.
George. Neighbors, you say? Well, dash the neighbors!
Yeah!
And dash the expense!
Yay!
Welcome to the family, boys!
Will this help the expense, Father?
Who's for a pony ride?
Sally!
Hello, nice to meet you. I'm Kelly.
Hello, Kelly. Sally.
And what's your name?
Nibs. I play in the battles.
Nibs, darling.
Would you like a mother?
Yes.
I'll be mother to you all!
Yes! Yes. She was about 11 now.
Yes.
What's the matter, child?
I couldn't find the house. Now everybody's got your mother. Except me.
Is your name Slightly?
Yes.
Then I am your mother.
How do you know?
Oh, I feel it in my bones. George, Mary, I have a son.
We actually flew and killed a pirate with two different hearts.
Oh, yes, that's going to cost a bit. What about you?
The horse.
The horse? Why not? You're not that stupid.
There could not have been a lovelier sight, but there was no one to see it, except a strange boy staring in at the window. Peter Pan had countless joys that other children can only dream of, but he was looking at the one joy from which he must be forever barred.
To live shall be an awfully big adventure.
Let's go, Peter.
Peter, you won't forget me, will you?
Me? Forget? Never.
Peter, will you come back?
To listen to the stories about me. Of course.
Goodbye, Peter.
You know that place between sleep and awake? The place where you still remember dreaming? That's where I'll always love you. That's where I'll be waiting. Goodbye, Wendy.
But I was never to see Peter Pan again. Now, I tell his stories to my children, and they will tell them to their children. And so it will go on, for all children grow up, except one.
It's not the end, I'm never far away. So close your eyes and dream, and I will seem to be here by your side, and I will mend the hurt you feel today. Say goodbye, just try to understand I'm late. Don't cry too much when I am gone, or talk about my name. There comes a time that we all know where we belong. Don't think of when we meet again, if it will be the same. Don't cry too much, just smile, be happy now, be strong.
do believe in fairies. I do believe in fairies. I do.
Pistol first.
Arnaki Stoller. That was one of those boys you hate, Captain. I could have shot him dead.
Arnaki Stoller.
One of those filthy, rotten little lost boys they hate so much, Captain. I could have put a bullet in him. But it was one of those boys that you hate with the white hot intensity of a thousand suns. I could have shot him dead.
Aye. And the sound of it would have brought Tiger Lily's natives upon us.
And so the dwarves started cheering with joy, and the prince married Snow White, and they lived happily ever after.
Yay!
Very kind children.
Yes. If you wish.
Catch your things.
Yes!
You too, Ethan.
soon. Don't throw